You're late. Starrick is making his move. The Piece of Eden is somewhere inside Buckingham Palace.
Let him have it.
I've seen your handiwork across the city. Perhaps you should trust my judgment.
I've been killing Starrick's henchmen. What have you been doing? Let's ask Henry, shall we?
I have been repairing your mistakes. Too much haste is too little speed.
Don't you call father at me.
That's Plato. And I am sorry, this doesn't involve anything you can destroy. Father was right, he never approved of your methods.
Father is dead!
Enough! I have just received word from my spies. At the palace ball tonight, Starrick plans to steal the Piece of Eden, and then eliminate all the heads of church and state.
Once more for old time's sake?
And then we're finished.
Agreed. So what's the plan?
Such an unexpected delight to visit you both. What is the news on the street?
Mrs. Disraeli, we have discovered that there is something inside Buckingham Palace that could threaten the...
What my sister's failing to say is that we require entrance into the ball tonight.
Impossible! Even if there were any invitation cards remaining, which there are not, someone of your lowly station...
If that damn fool Gladstone is attending this evening, they can have my card.
Perfect. Then I'll go alone.
Mrs. Disraeli, if you would be kind enough to inform my darling brother of the location of the Gladstone's residence, perhaps he could use his considerable skills to commandeer their cards.
What fun! Did you hear that, Dizzy? We're going to pinch the Gladstone's invitations.
Thank you for volunteering me, sweet sister.
Oh, a pleasure, brother dearest. Now, Mrs. Disraeli, if you would excuse me, I must visit with the Maharaja. It occurs to me that he may have a second set of plans to a certain vault.
The nerve of Evie. Treating me like a child.
Thank you.
Who's a good horse? Keep moving. Easy, girl. Easy. Atta girl. Tonight. They must have taken the invitations with them. You wouldn't happen to have seen two carriages pass by here just now?
I did, sir. One with a man in it, the other with a woman. They split up.
Where did the man go?
That way.
Thank you.
Mr. Gladstone.
Maybe I haven't been quite as delicate as I could have been, but still. Walk on, girl. Mrs. Gladstone's under guard. Better be cautious. Better wait until she's alone. Now is my chance. One should not attend the Queen's ball without making a proper entrance. Now for the invitations. What's this? Swords must be left at the door by order of the Queen. Freddy will know what to do. Easy, girl. Easy. Whoa, now! Who's a good horse? You are. Whoa, there! That's the way. Easy now! Steady on. Keep moving. Easy does it. Slow down now! Walk on, girl. Doing fine, girl. Whoa, easy. Let's go. Slow down. Who's a good horse? You are. Thank you.
You a cop or something?
Take it easy, Linton. Settle down now.
You in a challenge me then? Unfair to sneak up on someone from behind. That's cowards.
Some sort of commotion.
I'm not here to challenge you. I'm here to escort you to the police.
Whatever for? All I want is a little fun. Nothing like tossing some pub dwellers about, eh? No harm in it.
A couple of victims in the hospital. No harm in that, I suppose.
Wasted enough time.
stand for it. I can't believe them.
Who, sir?
The Order, of course. Everything I've ever done was for the Order. And now they're pretending I didn't do this.
I was getting bored.
You shouldn't be here.
Hey, piss off before I break your legs.
Even a nice locket, bunch of savages.
Does it matter? This thuggery is mad.
For you, my friend. Beg pardon? Unhand me, rascal! I said let me go!
Quiet down. That's enough out of you, Harley.
How do you know me? Rumors? The scandal sheets?
Your fame reaches beyond scandal sheets, sir.
What's going on over there?
How's that?
I read about you in the police files.
They're wrong. I'm an honorable man. I serve the interests of our father.
What on earth is the matter there?
Save your excuses for the police.
Help! I'm trapped! Someone help me!
That's the way.
Something out of a nightmare, that one. You did well.
A sad indictment of the state of London. We'll see about that.
Should we take out those bloody Fry twins and their renegade group? What say you?
Nothing to worry about.
Grab it!
Thank you, mister.
You're on the wrong side of the door, dear!
Stop me!
Where's he going?
Everything was to your satisfaction.
Enjoy! keep your voice down.
You ain't so bad after all, mister.
Quiet. I'm here to help.
Thank you, mister.
What a carriage you got there. Where did you buy it, if you don't mind me asking?
Ask all you want, Freddy. You'll never get an answer.
Damn it all. Was it my eyebrows?
Yes. And your face, voice, and body. Look, I've got an invitation to the Queen's ball tonight.
How did you come by that?
Freddy, there's to be an attack on the ball. I need to smuggle some weapons inside to prevent it.
Supposing I believe you? Only the Royal Guard carries weapons.
So?
Too easy.
For God's sake, Freddy.
Fine. I require a guard's uniform.
Done. I knew you'd come through.
Just promise me, Jacob, that you will return Mr. Gladstone's coach.
Of course.
That's the only explanation for this.
Charming. Now to hide the body.
Bit mad, that one.
Ready? Here I come.
Workers are treated like animals.
One uniform as requested.
It's still warm.
My gift to you?
I will meet you on the roof of Buckingham Palace.
You're such a romantic.
Suffering for the sake of luxury.
Interesting.
slice you open!
Thank you.
Hush now.
We thank you from the bottom of our hearts. Look at him trying to hide.
Blimey.
Would you like to meet with such a fate?
Look sharp.
Thank you, sir.
I'll bet he's a stranger than my mistake.
I caught you stealing! I caught you stealing!
It'll be all right.
You saved us!
Thank you.
head now. You'll be all right.
You ain't so bad after all, mister.
Fry twins apart and bring me the pieces!
That's a girl. Let's go. Easy, girl. Easy.
The rats who infest our street.
Another one for the grave digger.
There's a body here.
Thank you.
I believe that shall help you greatly.
Anyone would join the rooks is proof of their stupidity!
Show me what you've got!
All right, dear Mr. Fry.
Do me a good turn. Thank you.
You cheeky son!
Being here would be a very bad idea.
Got what you deserved.
very nice of you, dear, but it would mean...
I hope everything was to your satisfaction.
No. Looks like trouble.
Mate,
what?
Something wrong?
Bugger off! I'll kill you, I will. Do not get in my way.
Quiet, you. Settle down, Bunbury. If that's your real name.
You can't stop me. No one can. I'm here to claim this territory for the Blighters, under the orders of the Bludger herself. And so help me, I will finish what I've started.
To what end?
Not that it's any of your business, but if we build a Blighter stronghold, we can take Buckingham for ourselves, then the Blighters will rule all of London. Miss Lilla will be so proud of what we accomplished today.
Right. Well, good luck with that.
Get me out of here! Help me! I'm being kidnapped!
Slow down now.
That was a close one.
You've done well. Thank you.
Look no further, forever. Please make sure to come again.
Delighted to see you again, Miss Fry.
Your Highness, the plans detailing the renovations to Buckingham Palace have gone astray.
I suppose you will have to make do with the copies.
There are copies? Where?
Not so fast. First, I have a matter of some urgency. Carrying out my plan would require stealth and speed, qualities I know you possess.
Time is of the essence, Your Highness.
Then make this quick, my dear. The most influential men in Parliament remain beyond my reach. But these very men have sent for carriages to prepare for the ball tonight. Acquire an official carriage, and we shall drive the politicians to their destinations. Along the way, I will meet with them. And afterward, I shall tell you where to find the plans.
You're a shrewd negotiator.
One must be when one is so often underestimated.
Don't allow personal feelings to compromise the mission. What a mistake.
You over there! What's
like
got into
mess
you?
Is
come here!
The tops will be puking in the bushes at 3 a.m. and we'll be the ones cleaning it up.
Congratulations!
what are you going to do about it?
Is there a problem?
Well, yes, madam. I'm rather afraid of it. Your man is important to get. Beg your pardon.
And perhaps you might stop haranguing my driver and let
get
him
this
work.
Dashboard.
Be our cause, Miss Fry?
Climb up, Your Highness. Where are we headed?
Belgrave Square.
Easy now. Slow down. Whoa there.
Double. My son is anticipating my arrival.
Welcome, sir.
Your Highness, what a surprise.
Is life not about embracing the unexpected? I shall take but a few moments of your time. A matter of utmost importance must be discussed. When the Commonwealth seized the Punjab from my people.
It was not a seizure, but a rightful transaction.
Britain promised to protect me. By robbing me of my kingdom, Parliament acted in violation of the treaty signed with my family. Here, read it.
I was not aware.
Read. That is all I ask. You are one of the few in a position to help.
I will do what I can.
Thank you, sir.
Slowly now.
I trust you and your son will enjoy the ball this evening.
He is newly returned from Delhi. I will share what we have discussed. It is most disconcerting.
That proved quite valuable.
Where to now?
St. James's Park. I noticed Mr. Green did not accompany you.
He has other things to attend to.
Ah, a pity. You two seem to get along nicely.
Well, that was a problem, you see. One must not allow personal feelings to compromise one's mission.
That sounds like a quotation.
It is. From my father.
Ethan Fry.
You knew him?
No, unfortunately. But Mr. Green spoke of him. He sounded like an extraordinary man.
He was, Your Highness.
And your mother as well, Cecily Fry. She and your father were partners, inseparable. The only duo that came close to challenging Mr. Starrick. And very much in love, at least from the small amount I have been told.
Cecily, I wish I could have met her.
From what Mr. Green gathered, you share much in common. Your intelligence, for one.
Father never spoke of her. What would Mr. Green know? He was only a boy when he trained with my father.
Children can be quite perceptive, Miss Fry.
To Parliament, please. On the double.
Yes, sir.
Good day, sir.
Why, what are you doing here, Your Highness?
I know how busy your days have been of late. A few moments of your time is all I require.
This is all rather unorthodox, but continue.
Britain was to protect me according to the treaty my family signed. Instead, she took my land. And now I hear Britain intends to strengthen her ties to India. Perhaps it is time to return the Punjab to her people.
The Queen has supplied you with an annual income for God knows how long, and now you bite the hand that feeds you?
It is not a matter of money. I cannot stand idle and watch my homeland subjected to the yoke of an outsider's rule. My people are treated as slaves. I will die poor 1,000 times over if only to see them free.
Your passion moves me, Your Highness. What would you have me do?
Take this copy of the wrongful treaty and defend my claim to the throne. Help disengage the Punjab from British rule.
I shall speak up, but I am only one voice. I cannot promise anything but a show of support.
That is more than enough. Thank you, sir.
My pleasure, Your Highness.
Good day, sir.
May God bless you. Only one more remains. To the Gladstone residence.
Do you miss India?
I remember that my mother smelled of cinnamon. And when she cradled me in her arms in the summer heat, I would hold so still that she fell asleep. When I lost my kingdom, it hurt. For truly, when they took my mother away, I saw her again 2 years before she died. The summer long since faded. I miss her. I miss India. I love India because I love my mother.
Will you ever return?
I have petitioned the government several times, but they withhold their permission. Do not be fooled by appearances, Miss Fry. I am in many ways a prisoner.
Perhaps we may work together more closely for your cause in the future.
I would like that very much, Miss Fry.
Slow down.
To the Synopian Club, straight away.
Good day, Mr. Gladstone.
Mr. Singh.
You are a hard man to pin down.
I know what this is about. Your parlor tricks have worn off. Your Majesty has tired of you. So now you come begging for scraps.
You wound me deeply, sir. My people deserve freedom. I am here to fight for them.
Why did you lose the Punjab? I shall tell you, Your Highness. You were outgunned, outmaneuvered, and simply outclassed. Yes, the Sikhs deserve freedom. I hope with British help and progress, they shall achieve it.
Then why do they cry out for their king?
Britain has a duty to bring about peace. It is an enormous responsibility. And I value your guidance and advice, along with that of Parliament. But it's our burden to rule India. And certainly not the duty of a forgotten leader who has not seen his country for 20 years. I apologize for being so frank, but one must not tell lies to a king.
Your honesty is most enlightening.
When I become Prime Minister, I intend to push for peace, but it will be a long and slow process. And I am afraid I can almost guarantee you will never see India again.
If my people are free, then my imprisonment shall be no burden.
Perhaps your idealism is real. Although, after observing the tigers wandering the grounds of your lush, expensive estate, forgive me for doubting it. Much luck, Your Highness, with your lobbying. I hope my advice has done some good.
Far more than your policies thus far. But I hold out hope that you will make progress. My people are counting on it. Thank you, Miss Fry.
for forwarding my cause?
Oh, you are welcome. I hope some good comes of it, despite Mr. Gladstone's vitriol.
Those of us with the largest hearts protect them the most. Your father, for instance. From what I understand, he was extraordinarily sad. Broken, even, after your mother's passing. That kind of pain can blind us, cause us to say outlandish things to protect the ones we love. It's time you returned this carriage and recovered those plans. They are located in Buckingham Palace. The Queen keeps them among her personal papers in the White Drawing Room. I wish you a good evening, Miss Evie Fry.
And to you, Your Highness.
How you doing, Evie?
There you go. Easy, girl. Believe their eyes.
Nice day for a bit of bloodshed, isn't it?
By your command.
Miss Graves, known in London as the Bludger, accepts the terms to this gang war. The fight shall permit the use of all weapons. May the best gang emerge victorious.
Howlett.
Of course he'd arrive in that.
Miss Fry?
Hand him your weapons. We must enter unarmed. Go on in, sir and madam.
Dear me, I am soon to become prime minister.
What in the blazes is our carriage doing here?
Did I hear something?
No, just the voices in your own head.
And yet, they are so much more pleasant than yours.
Charming.
Aren't I?
I shall go and find the Peace of Eden.
As you wish. I'm off to meet Freddy.
The plans are located in the white drawing room, which is most likely locked. The captain of the guard will have a key. Keep your mouth closed, and this will be over before you know it.
Who are you? That hurts. My arm.
What's going on?
No good will come of that.
You mark my words.
That hurts. The lady is with me.
Much obliged.
Madam? That hurts. My arm. Gentle. My arm! Gentle! My arm! Gentle! My arm! Gentle. That hurts.
Pleasant dreams. The plans are somewhere nearby. Now for the vault. Jacob's most likely off stealing another carriage somewhere, or accidentally pushing the Queen down a flight of stairs. There you are! I have someone I'm simply dying for you to meet. Come with me! Your Majesty, may I present Miss Evie Fry?
You are the one responsible for Mr. Gladstone's mishap.
Your Majesty, I apologize.
The cake is particularly good. Enjoy the ball.
I really must be going.
Miss Fry, may I have this dance?
Mr. Starrick, you've had your fun, but the game is over.
Listen. One, two, three. One, two, three. Time is a wonderful thing, Miss Fry. It heals all wounds. We may make mistakes while dancing, but the mazurka ends, and then we begin again. Problem is, everyone forgets. They trip on the same mistakes over and over.
People can learn.
Can they? Isn't everyone around you repeating the same steps? But if one man could remember the dance, could know the time, then he could change things for the better.
I have had enough.
This dance is nearly over. Soon, the people will forget the generation on this terrace. The ruin you nearly wrought on London. When the music ceases, Miss Fry, your time is up. And mine begins.
Starrick peppered the regulars with his own men and took several guards hostage. Your weapons are in there.
Look. Kill the imposters and rescue the captives.
How? It's impossible to tell the difference.
Oh, ye of little faith.
Here! Where the hell is the soldier? I like the god rumbling!
to find the real Royal Guards. I'll get you out.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, mate. What the hell was that?
I'll smash your face in!
Done here. Hold still for a moment.
You have my thanks.
Now, what could that be? Let's make a mess! Don't get in my way!
I can hit him from here!
Hide him before it's a bit of smoke.
The key to the waltz is one must lead with one's right foot.
Oh, my!
Everything all right, my dear?
Do you require assistance?
I never liked balls. Here, the location of the vault. Go!
Just like that? No plan?
No time for plans. I'll catch up as soon as I'm rid of this infernal contraption.
What? What are you doing?
Exploiting. I warned you, my boy. But you do not listen.
Requies Carton Pace.
The shroud was never meant for you.
You would rather destroy the fa-
Rectify my mistake. Another crime. I will begin again. And this new life. I admire you.
Come closer.
Ugh.
London will perish without me.
You flatter yourself. I would have created a paradise.
The city belongs to the people. You are but one man.
I am at the very top of the order!
You were, Mr. Starrick.
You were.
Shame we won't be partners anymore.
It's for the best, isn't it?
Are you gonna wear the shroud and run London?
Whatever it gives, it takes from someone else. You'd continue to age without me. You'd become like father.
A fate worse than death.
Will you wear it?
After you sorted out the boroughs, the chaos I caused, I couldn't compete.
Jacob Fry, stepping back. Who's blackmailing you? Is it George?
He wouldn't dare. I've missed you.
Me too. Would it be possible to continue where we left off?
I'd love nothing more.
I'm starting to think Father didn't know everything about everything. Henry!
It's a big world out there. With London in the center.
Perhaps not the very center.
I came as soon as I could. Do not worry. I'll head back to the train. Did I jeopardize the mission?
Henry, you saved it. I think you belong in the field with me.
A carriage! Nicely done, Freddy.
Mr. Abeline, please.
Your Majesty.
Miss Fry.
You've met before?
Did I never mention?
Mr. Abeline informs me that you three are responsible for saving my life. Is this true?
It is, Your Majesty.
Evie Fry, step forward. And you?
My brother, ma'am. Jacob Fry. And this is Mr. Henry Green.
Mr. Fry? Mr. Green. Kneel. I invest you all in the Order of the Sacred Garter.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
If you are as adept as Mr. Abeline implies, I may call on you.
Sergeant Abeline tends to exaggerate, Your Majesty.
We shall meet again. And Miss Fry?
Ma'am?
Should you want it? I saved you some cake.
Father would be proud of you.
Dame Evie Fry.
Sir Jacob Fry.
Race you to the train.
You're on.
You've done a wonderful job of helping the children of this city.
So what you're saying is, I'm a hero.
We pitched in what we could to properly express our gratitude.
Thank you, Clara.
Oh, good. You're both here. I have something to give you.
That really isn't necessary.
More gifts? You spoil me, Greenie.
Templar numbers are dwindling, and I hate to admit it, but the Rooks are thriving.
Did you hear that, Evie? Thriving.
Your time in London has been well spent. I am proud of you.
Freddy, I hardly recognized you in your police togs.
You certainly scrub up well.
I thank you for your help in collecting these bounties. I am impressed with all you have accomplished. And I wish you luck with your future endeavors.